test this thing out and see if I can't hook something up for you guys. Guys, I'm back down here on the Homer Spit and I love it. Just love this place. There's an otter over there to my left. The wildlife down here is unbelievable. You got otters cruising back and forth here, just eating clams constantly. You got an unreal abundance of eagles flying overhead. When it turns to be sunny like this, it's just fantastic. 2 hours ago, it was pouring rain, so we're very, very fortunate that the sun came out. But last year, I was down here and made a video that didn't really show how to fish the Homer Spit. It just showed the types of fish you can catch down here. So with this video, I'm going to go a little more in depth. I'm going to go and show you the setup that I use, the bait that I use, and hopefully I'll catch some fish. It's the tide's coming in. I was hoping to be down here on low tide, but that's not gonna happen. So we'll give it a shot, best shot, government try, and see what happens. But I mean, the outcome doesn't really matter because it is sunny and gorgeous right now. So anyways, let's see if we can catch some fish.
Alright guys, so the things that you're going to need for this setup are hooks. I use any sort of bait hook, size 5. You're going to need weight. I have anywhere between 1 to 3 ounce weights. You're going to need a three-way swivel. And you're going to need some extra fishing line. Alright guys, so for this setup, like I said, you're going to need this three-way stop. Or swivel, I'm sorry. And what I do is I take and I thread through one eyelet. And I don't know what this knot's called. I've used it since the beginning of time. You spin it around 5 or 6 times. There will be a hole that forms down by the eyelet here through the fishing line. See, I don't know if you can see it or not. Anyways, there it is. You put the loose end through that hole, okay? And then to finish it off, there's a second hole, a larger hole that is formed that you then thread that small piece of line through one more time. Goodness, pain in the rear. It's like that. It's probably the worst visual explanation of it known to man, but that's it. Put it in this eyelet, spin the line around 5 or 6 times, go back down here, stick this shorter piece through where the hole forms in the line, and then back up through where there's a larger hole that forms right here. Pull that tight. Now this monofilament line seems to get slippery. So I take and just kiss it with a flame, pinch that off, tie it nice and tight. That way I know for sure that thing will not let loose on itself. So you do that knot on there, you do it on your whatever ounce weight you choose to use. I preferably like 2 ounce. Spin, 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 put it through the hole that's formed on the bottom, followed by taking it back through the large hole on top, pull tight, kiss with the flame to make a big kind of bubble. Ooh, that was more than a kiss. Woo. And then pull, see how it slips on itself? Pull that nice and tight. Make sure it's not going anywhere. There you go, you got the first bit of this setup. So then you copy that with the longer piece of line and do the same thing with the hook. And then you're good, you got your setup. So I'll probably end up fast forwarding this so you guys don't need to see me do it, but.
I did a little research and found out the name of this knot that I'm tying is referred to as a clinch knot. I'll put a little diagram up here in the right hand corner. You can either pause the video and kind of look at the step by steps, or you can just go and Google it and give yourself some time to practice it. Super simple knot, very reliable. The only thing I recommend is that you go and kind of burn the edge like I was showing you when you're using that monofilament, because it's just slippery. I've had them come undone before under a lot of tension, and the quickest and easiest fix that I found is just burn the end like I'm doing, give it a little bit of a bump that it can't pass the line underneath itself, and just eliminates the whole ability for it to slip. So hopefully that's a little more helpful than watching me fumble around with my sausage fingers.
So there you go, you gotta wait, you got your hook attached, you have your setup. So I'm gonna make a couple more of these, and I'll meet you guys back out there on the beach.
You can hear me. It's pretty windy. I don't have my mic on, but that awesome sunny day pretty much disappeared. At least it's not raining, but it's super windy. Got two Irish lords. This beach was pretty packed, but it's really slow right now. I'll send this thing out there, see if I can't get anything. I'm just putting herring on at the moment. I had some squid on, they didn't seem too interested in that. Just put herring on. They started biting a little better, but cast this thing out and see if I can't hook something up for you guys. Is you want to try and get out to those pillars. Cast as far as you can to those pillars. If you can get here at low tide, it's better. But the fish seem to congregate right around those pillars out there. It's kind of like a man-made reef or something, but it's more or less where they like to hang out. So the closer you get to those, the better your options are at catching the fish. Alright, I think I'm gonna wrap it up. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get a fish to show you guys. If you wanna check out my other video, I was catching an abundant amount of fish then. Look at this. All day long. Right? But yeah. This go around, it isn't all day long. I got two Irish lords, not on video, and crows. But I did get to watch an eagle for a while, so that was pretty sweet. Anyways, I hope that helps. And when you come down, good luck. Have some patience, and try to shoot for low tide. This high tide thing did not work out like I wanted it to. And once again, sorry I didn't get any fish on camera, but is what it is, right? It's not called catching, it's called fishing. All right, thanks for watching.